So far we have done with alcohols with one OH group on it. Now we will do alcohols which have two OH groups. Okay. And similarly, then we'll see alcohols if they have three OH groups. Okay. Now currently what we'll be studying is most about this, which is the vicinal diols. So if you have vicinal diols, how to prepare, what are the reactions that are involved. So glycols is the common name for 1,2-diol. Okay, so if you have ethane 1,2-diol, this is what is glycol is. Okay, if I just remind you, whenever we have an alkane, especially if you have ethane, for instance, this is the conformation which we usually write. Okay? This is how the conformation. This is the Sawhorse projection which we have. Sawhorse projection. If I convert this Sawhorse projection into Newman projection, then we will write this as the back carbon, and then on the front carbon, we will showcase this way, and back carbon we will show this way. And all of these are being hydrogens. So this is the ethane conformer, which I'm sure you are aware of. If at all I rotate this by 60 degrees angle, okay, in the back, then we would have same molecule, except that on the back you will get 60 degrees rotation. Okay. So it should happen to be this way, H, H, and H. We call this as the eclipsed form, and this as the staggered form. Okay. What we learned is that staggered is more stable compared to eclipse, because that would have least amount of van der Waal repulsions. We also learned the same logic to be applied when you have to discuss about 1,2-diols also. So suppose if the same diagram I have to draw it for 1,2-diols, then how does it look like? So basically it is about this. You have OH and OH. If this is front carbon and back carbon, okay, then one of the places would be with OH here, backside also one of the places will be with OH. So in that case I can replace one of the places here. Let's say this is OH, and backside also I replace that with OH. So then here also, if you see, you would have OH here, and I'm writing this as OH here, and this also has OH. Okay. Now the name of this staggered form is called GOSH, correct? Because when you have two different groups on two carbons, then you will have four different forms. Just to remind you, one is fully eclipsed, partially eclipsed, GOSH form, and anti-form. These two are staggered forms, and these two are eclipsed forms. In generally, anti is always more stable compared to all. But when you have glycols, in the glycol, what you would observe is that this hydrogen and oxygen will make an hydrogen bonding here. Because of which, if you see all the conformers of glycol, all the conformers of glycol, GOSH would be more stable compared to anti, compared to partially eclipsed, compared to fully eclipsed. This is something we got to understand. Okay. All right. But when you add it to water, on adding glycol to water, then hydrogen bonding is done with solvent. Hydrogen bonding is done with solvent and that would be more effective. Therefore, in these cases, now anti would be more stable than gauche. So gauche form is only when you have a non-polar solvent or in case if it is in a gaseous medium. Otherwise, anti will always be more stable than gauche, than partially eclipsed and fully eclipsed. Okay. So this is the minimum idea you got to recall from conformers, what we learned. Now going with the preparation of glycols. The first method of preparation is hydroxylation. Hydroxylation is also something which we have learned when we did hydrocarbons, especially in alkenes. Okay. Right. So let me remind you what was the hydroxylation we have done. There are two types of hydroxylation, syn-hydroxylation and anti-hydroxylation. So if you have any alkene and you react that with Bayer's reagent, then we would definitely get OH this way. Okay. What is Bayer's reagent? I'll write it as BR. Bayer's reagent is alkaline, dilute, cold, 1% KMnO4. So that means it is a very, very mild oxidizing agent. This mild oxidizing agent, again, we don't have to go through the entire mechanism. One minimum idea you should have is what it does. This would make, some kind of adduct this way. Some kind of an adduct this way with double bond, and then this O minus from here, there is O minus that is going to come. This bond will close here, thereby it would make it as O minus here, O minus here, plus MnO2 OH. MnO2 minus. MnO2 plus, 1H plus is there. So this on hydrolysis, H2O, we would get it as alcohol. We get this as OH and OH. And this manganese would become MnO2 OH minus. So this is how we will get glycols. Now in here, if you take cis alkene, I told you how to understand the stereochemistry of it. So when it comes to stereochemistry, the arrangement is cis plus syn, because it is a syn addition, will always give us erythro. So here, suppose if I take an alkene this way, cis, on which hydroxylation is done, right? Syn addition is done. That means OH and OH groups are added from the same side. From here on, both of them are added from the same side. This is syn addition. In that case, we will get this as erythro. Erythro means OH on the same side. This way, this is erythro. Correct. So therefore, if you have a cis plus syn, you will get erythro. If you have trans plus syn, because it is only syn hydroxylation, I will get it as 3O. Okay. So as an example, if I put it through, suppose if I actually have a molecule this way, double bond here, and I treat that with Bayer's reagent, and on hydrolysis I'm asking you the product H2O. I'm asking you the product. The minute you come across this, first thing you see, this is trans and I need to get syn addition, so I need to get 3O products. That means both the OH should be on the opposite sides. So if I take one OH here, then I have to take another OH. Above there is methyl group, below there is an ethyl group. So these are, I can get this in two possibilities. One, adding from the up, adding from down. So these are the two possibilities I can get. These are the two 3O products I'll get. And if one 3O product is dextro rotation, then other will be lever rotation. Okay. And both would be mirror images of each other. And since they are mirror images of each other, I can say these are enantiomeric pair, and both being equal amount, this would also form 50% and 50%. If you have 50%, 50% enantiomeric mixture, then we call it as racemic mixture. So we'll get the glycols of racemic mixture. Right, beta, this point is clear, right? So this is the way you need to think. And what is happening? Syn addition, I hope that is clear with KMnO4. KMnO4, right here, where it comes to syn hydroxylation. KMnO4 Bayer's reagent. I'll write this as KMnO4 by OH minus cold, which means Bayer's reagent. And OSO4 in sodium bisulfide will also act same or same types. These two are same types. So both will give the same products. But if it is anti-hydroxylation, that is done by peroxy acids plus hydration. If you do this, then you will get an anti-addition. So let me remind you how you need to think anti-hydroxylation. Suppose if you have a double bond here and I treat that with some peroxy acid. Peroxy acid will have a bond like this. We have O, H, O, C, double bond O, and some R. This is the bond which you will have. Okay. Or maybe I'll write this in better form. O and H. This is how it is. This is peroxy acid. So when an alkene comes in contact with the peroxy acid, the pi present here will try to attack this oxygen because this is localized. As it attacks, this oxygen will take away electrons because that oxygen needs an empty orbital for it, where the attack can happen. At the same time, the lone pair present on this oxygen would immediately attack on the carbon which is getting positive charge. So because of this attack, now what would happen? We will have double bond this way. Okay, sorry. The double bond is lost and I would get oxygen this way with hydrogen positive charge. Because hydrogen is losing on two sides, no? So it will get positive charge. This is called oxonium ion. If you remember, we discussed this in alkenes. Okay. So once you get the oxonium ion, so if you keep this oxonium ion for standing, it will release out this H plus. Okay. And you will get this as O, which is epoxide. Till this part, this is the first step of the reaction and this is called epoxidation. So it is simply epoxidation. See, in epoxidation, the addition of oxygen has happened from the same side. So I can say this is syn addition. So till this part, it is syn addition. Epoxidation is always a syn addition reaction. But as I said, this is step one. But if you continue to react this epoxide, okay, and if you make this epoxide which has formed here, okay, and if you keep that in same medium, that means if I keep that in acidic medium only, correct, then the water in the acidic medium would attack on one of the places here. The water will attack on one of the oxygens and oxygen will take away electrons. Okay. But while it is attacking, it won't attack from the same side from which your OH is removed. So it will always attack from the back side because it is like an SN2 reaction, simultaneous attack and simultaneous removal. Okay. So this time, what type of an attack it is happening? It is happening with an anti-addition. So there is an anti-addition which is happening here. Got it? So because of which, what would happen now? Like this way, you will have this OH would come on this side and water will be attacked on the other side. Okay, plus. And remove this H plus, and we would have this as OH on this side and the other OH on this side. Got it? So overall, now the hydroxy, now the glycol which has formed, diol which has formed, is by anti-addition. Overall, it is an anti-addition reaction. Okay. So few things we need to take care of here is that this reaction can be done both in acidic medium as well as basic medium. Suppose once you have an epoxide formation, I'll do with an example, okay? So suppose if I take an example, and this is an epoxide which is formed. This epoxide will have two different routes in two mediums. Suppose if I take H3O plus, suppose if I take OH minus, how does this happen? First in H3O plus. In H3O plus, first thing, it will again take an H plus from this and it will become oxonium ion. After it becomes an oxonium ion, the water will attack. Water has two places to attack. This is location one, this is location two. You see the carbon in the first position here. I'll call it as one and two, let's say. Okay. Or sorry, we start from here. One, two, and three. So carbon and carbon two position. At carbon two position, delta positive is more stable. So therefore, oxygen will always attack. Always think like a non-classical carbocation. So as it attacks there, this group would remove. So from here, oxygen will remove. Then what do we have here now? This would have OH group here and water will attack from this side. And it removes the H plus ion here. And thereby, we will get this OH and OH as the final product. The product would be same in basic medium also, but this time, how does the reaction take place? You see, first, there is no source for it to get protonated. So the lone pair would remain the same. And it would not become oxonium ion. It will exist as an epoxide only. And then OH minus will attack. OH minus will attack on this carbon, so that this oxygen will come out. Therefore, you will have this as OH and O minus. Then on addition of water here, you will get this as OH and OH. Okay. Product is same, but the mechanism is different. The attack is always different. Okay. So in basic medium, it is strictly going to be SN2. But in acidic medium, it is not completely SN2. It is an attack on, you know, more delta positive carbon. Attack should be always on more delta positive carbon. So this is a basic difference in acidic medium and basic medium. But the product is same. Okay. Overall reaction is an anti-addition, correct? Unlike that. So that's why it is called an anti-hydroxylation reaction. Okay. So by hydroxylation, we will be able to get the diols what we need. Okay, this is preparation one. Second preparation by which you can get diol is aldehyde. Aldehyde or ketone. Aldehyde or ketone. Reaction in magnesium, which is amalgamated, and water. This reaction. This reaction will also give diols. I will take with an example here. Suppose if I take any particular aldehyde or ketone. So basically carbonyl compound. We write this as double bond O. Okay. And magnesium, when it is present with mercury, magnesium will be weak donor of electrons, but it will donate electrons, but not as strong as what it is, because if it is a strong donor, these electrons will be immediately reacting, you know, with water what we add. Got it? which is not what we are expecting. So that's why magnesium is amalgamated with mercury. So these two electrons will act on the carbonyl as a nucleophile, because this would have delta positive and delta negative because of electronegativity. And as soon as they attack, this oxygen will take away electrons and it would have a formation of O minus. Okay, so it would have a formation of O minus, and here also it will become C minus. Correct. So you can see that it will become C minus there. Okay. Now, one electron has gone here, it has become plus. Okay. One electron, if it has gone, it has become plus there. Now, so what I can say here is that when the electron approaches here, imagine this way, no? Suppose double bond ko main aise likh do, O minus and carbon plus. Okay. So if I give one electron to this, what does it become? It would become a radical. Okay. And I said magnesium releases electrons very slowly. So imagine there are 2 moles of this. If at all I have 2 moles of this, correct? One electron is attacking here. Each molecule. So for 2 molecules, you will have 2 electrons being attacked to them. So I'll have 2 moles of these dots here now. One electron has gone for one carbon, second electron has gone for second carbon. Okay. So if it is unclear, let me show you one more same thing here. Like I took 2 of them here and one electron has attacked this. Okay, beta. So I will get 2 of this. Now these 2, because there is an radical formation, radical will try to terminate themselves. So when they terminate, we will have O minus and a bond formed here, O minus. Okay, both these molecules are terminated. This type of a form is seen, and this on hydrolysis will give us OH and OH. So again, we got diols. These are vicinal diols. Is that clear? So we got this as a vicinal diols. So this vicinal diols, which we got, if at all we have all of these R groups, R1, R2. Imagine there are no hydrogens. All of them are some alkyl groups. Then we call this particular diol as pinacol. This is known as pinacol. Think the preparation is clear, beta? So these are the 2 ways by which we can prepare. Okay. So mainly these are the 2 reactions. One is hydroxylation. The other one is, you know, formation of pinacols. Now we learned what is the preparation. Let us see what are the reactions which you come across this diols. Okay. So first of the reaction is SOCl2. How does it respond to SOCl2? See, if you take a simple, you know, ethane diol, CH2CH2OH, which is glycol, and we react that with SOCl2. You remember how ROH was behaving? When it comes to ROH, when we react that with SOCl2, it will form RCl plus SO2 plus HCl. And this would be SNI mechanism. This is SNI mechanism, if you can remember, right? Now, the same thing is applied here also at 2 locations. From 2 locations, this is happening. You will get this as CH2Cl and CH2Cl. On both sides, the mechanism is driven by SNI. So it is an SNI mechanism. Similar thought, if you get to react with red phosphorus plus I2. Okay. So red phosphorus plus I2, usually what happens, phosphorus when it reacts with I2, it would form Pi3. Correct? Its general tendency is to form Pi3. So imagine as if you are reacting with Pi3 only. So again, when it comes to PI3, the reaction is quite similar. We'll have I here, okay? All right. Now, one important note that is to be made here is that if you check out bond dissociation energy of carbon iodine as compared to versus bond dissociation energy of iodine and iodine, then iodine is better, I2 is better. So if you consider this, then we can say the bond dissociation energy of I2 is better. Okay. So wherever we have vicinal iodides like this, because their bond with carbon is not very strong, they would immediately, and they are also very bulky groups, no? They will repel each other. So that's why they will immediately come out of that molecule and make it, you know, alkene and come out of I2. Come out as I2. I think this is clear, right? So this is one important thing to remember. So wherever you have vicinal iodides, this only happens with vicinal iodides, not with everything, not with other halides. Okay, so remember this part. So with vicinal iodides, what we got? So if at all I continue to make this reaction happen further, because so far what we checked it out, that if you react this with CH2OH, okay, then this is what is formed with red phosphorus and I2. This is the reaction which we have seen. Okay, but this reaction won't be stable. I mean, this product won't be stable. It would immediately convert back to alkene and come out as I2. Okay. I hope that point is clear better. This is with red phosphorus and I2. So when you react with red phosphorus I2, you'll get only alkene. That is the end product. But now you see, I'm just trying to improvise on that. Suppose instead of reacting with red phosphorus I2, what if the action with HI? How does it respond to HI reaction? HI is a strong acid. So because it is a strong acid, what we can assume that if you have OH groups here, got it? You know that first protonation will happen. Lone pair will attack from here. Here also lone pair will attack H+. Both side protonation happens. Yeah. So if I take 2 moles of HCl, concentrated HCl, first they will get CH2OH2+ here. Similarly, I'll get CH2OH2+ here. Both are good living groups. I- those 2 moles of iodine, both will attack from here and both water molecules will leave. And product I will get is CH2, I and I. Okay. But if you have given limited amount of HI, okay, so then where does the product end? The product will end again at alkene only plus I2. Correct. This is what happens. But if you give excess, so CH2, I and I, now in excess HI. So in case of excess HI, how does it happen? First, I2 will come out. I2 is coming out. So we will have this as CH2 double bond CH2. And you can see this is nothing but a simple alkene. So in alkene, electrophilic addition will take place. So again, it will attack on H+. We'll get this as CH3, CH2+, Markovnikov's addition, remember? So then I- will attack here. So we will get this as CH3, CH2I. So reaction will eventually stop here. Okay. So I guess you understood how to react with one more or 2 moles, or if it is excess, how the reaction happens. Is this clear better? Fourth type of reaction which we must be interested in is concentrated H2SO4. To treat that with concentrated H2SO4. Okay. You take any glycol, here, and that when we treat that with concentrated HI, H plus. Okay. Then it would form this oxirane. This is called oxirane. Okay. And the name of this oxirane is 1,4-dioxane. Right? 1,4-dioxane. Okay. So basically what is happening, first 1 mole will attack as 1 mole will become H2O plus. Okay. The second mole of water which is present here, OH and OH glycol, this mole will attack here and this mole will attack here. Okay, beta. And as they attack, this group is removed, this group is removed. So 2 moles will attack this way to finally give us this dioxane. Okay, this is the mechanism expected. This is with concentrated H2SO4. So it is removing 2 moles of water. 2 moles of water has been removed out of this. Okay. Concentrated H2SO4 is a good dehydrating agent. That is the reason why it is happening like this. If you take concentrated H3PO4, it is also a good dehydrating agent. Concentrated H3PO4 is also a good dehydrating agent, but not a very strong oxidizing agent. So there won't be any oxidation that is done. But these 2 moles, if you check out, okay, instead of any cyclization, and they would have only formation as an ether. On one side, it will form an ether. That's all. Okay. On one side, it is forming an ether. So basically, imagine this way. I have OH and OH2 plus weak acid, hai na beta? H3PO4. The H plus availability is very less. Okay. So both sides, H plus addition will not happen. This with another OH and OH is present in this one. So the lone pair from here will attack here and it will dehydrate. And doing that, you will get this product. Alright. If it was a concentrated H2SO4, the H plus availability is so high, with all oxygens it is getting, you know, protonation. But H3PO4, the H plus availability is less. So it will protonate at only one location and that will leave out H2O and the other molecule will attack, makes an ether formation. Next, oxalic acid. How does this behave in oxalic acid? So if I take OH and OH glycol and react that with COOH, COH, because this is oxalic acid, on heating, it will dehydrate to form CH2 double bond CH2. Okay. And oxalic acid will convert into carbon dioxide and H2O. It will convert into 2 moles of carbon dioxide and H2O. Okay. Imagine it's like an acid-base reaction. Okay. So basically, here it is OH and this is giving H plus. OH and H plus. Okay. So COO minus. COO minus. On heating, carboxylate salts, when heating, it will come as carbon dioxide. So 2 moles of carbon dioxide plus 2 moles of electrons. Okay. And here these two are coming out. So you can imagine it is forming like a here CH2. All right, complete structure. CH2, CH2. Imagine water aa jayega to yahan pe plus aa raha hai. There are 2 electrons which are released, will make it as 2 radicals. So I'll get this as dot and dot. 2 radicals will form alkene. So it will form CH2 double bond CH2. So I guess the mechanism is clear. So that's with the oxalic acid. Okay. Now, these are the major reactions which you will see when it comes to glycol C. Okay. Now, when you have glycols, this kind of diols, when you react it with H2SO4, okay, It depends upon how crowded it is. Now, suppose in case if you have lot of groups on it, I told you that what is pinnacle. So let me write down that. Now what we are doing is pinnacle one rearrangement reaction. Okay, this is one very, very typical J advanced question, beta. Every year, one question will come from this area for sure. Now, let me give you some briefing. It is a four-step reaction. Okay. And this is completely intramolecular reaction. Okay. There would be no cross products. Would be formed. Okay. That means some byproducts which are formed as a question here. Okay. So what does that mean? Suppose if at all I take, what is the overall reaction? First, let me tell you what is the pinnacle-pinnacolone reaction. So first of all, I need to take a pinnacle. If you remember what is pinnacle here, you will have R1, R2, OH, R1, R2, OH. This type of a look is what we call it as pinnacle. Okay, an alcohol which is vicinal to each other and having alkyl groups is called pinnacle. Now this pinnacle on heating, on reacting with H plus or H2SO4, got it? Reacting with H2SO4 plus. What would happen here is that we will get this as R1, R2, and whether it is R1 or R2, one of them will migrate on this side. Anyone will migrate, and the leftover part will become ketone with R2. This is how the reaction takes place. And this formation of ketone is an own, no? The pinnacle will become pinnacolone. So fundamentally, what is it? I hope you understood. Okay. Now, let us see the mechanism with an example. Suppose, if I take a simple alkyl pinnacle, where I have CH3, OH and OH. This, if you treat with H plus, the lone pair present on oxygen would immediately attack on H plus. Both sides OH group is symmetrical. Whether you attack from left side OH or right side OH, it doesn't matter. Okay? It is the same. So as soon as the attack takes place now, so we would have this group as OH2 plus. Here we have OH. I'll write this as methyl groups. So we have all methyl groups. So obviously it is a good leaving group. So this group will leave. Okay. Screen is getting freezed. Yeah, it's fine. Water has left. So what we got here is a carbocation, correct? So we got methyl, OH. By removing water, we got a carbocation, okay? You know, carbocation can be made stabilized, but this is already at the tertiary carbon. Let me remind you, beta. Suppose if at all I have carbon with all three methyl groups on it, okay, this one, and I have one more carbon which is a primary carbon, which is like this. Between these two, which is more stable? If you have carbocation here, 3 degree, and this one, out of these two, if you check out the stability, okay, although it is a 3 degree, it has 9 alpha hydrogens, very good hyperconjugation, inductive effect, wagera wagera. It has quite a good stability, but it has not, thing compared to the stability of this group. Reason being, this will form a non-classical carbocation. Oxygen will immediately donate the electrons and it will complete the octet. Are you getting this? Okay. So, hamesha non-classical carbocation would always be more stable. Okay, this type of a carbocation is also called as octet completed carbocation, OCC, or non-classical carbocation, NCC. So OCCs or NCCs are highly stable compared to that of classical carbocations, because classical carbocations have, you know, empty orbital, or we can say that as incomplete octet. So they have an incomplete octet form. So naturally, incomplete octet ko stability ke basis pe dekhenge, it is not as stable as that of a complete octet. Okay. Now observe here. Considering that you understood this logic, right? So observe that part here. Here, what is happening? We already have this carbocation at the tertiary position, but what if this carbocation moves here? If it comes to this position, if it comes to this position, then the lone pair on oxygen will immediately connect back and make it even more stable, or no? And that will make it non-classical carbocation. So there is definitely a chance for rearrangement of that carbocation, even though it is tertiary. But for that, I have to remove one of the methyl groups from there, correct? So that's why one of the methyl group will migrate here. So as soon as that methyl migrates here, so what is the product I'll get now? The methyl migrates there. So then I would have, you know, that methyl has gone here. Now I have carbocation here and OH group here, and that methyl has transferred here. So we'll have methyl, methyl, and methyl. And here also there is one methyl. Okay, so we got 1-2 methyl shift. So I hope you understood that. So 1-2 methyl shift has happened here. So once you get that, the lone pair present on oxygen will try to complete the octet for that. So we will get the same product with that double bond closing. Okay. So if that double bond is closed here now, so how does that look like now? You see, remove this part and there will be a double bond formation here with OH plus. And remove that H plus, you will get the final product. Okay. The final product looks something like this. So we have 3 methyl groups, got it, which had a double bond O with methyl group on. Removing that H plus. Because you got this. This is pinacolone. This is what is pinacolone. I hope you got that. Yeah. So this is how you'll get the pinacolone. Okay. Now, suppose if you have 2 different groups, then how do we get the pinacolones? What kind of a groups I will get? So let me start with few examples here. So there are a lot of variety of examples we can do this, do here. No? Check it out. Suppose I have 2 groups like this here. One side they have 2 phenyls. The other side I have 2 methyl groups. And I have OH and OH. And then H plus has been added. Now, it is not symmetrical on both the sides, correct? So there are methyl groups on one side, there is phenyl groups on one side. So I can have this lone pair attacking. I can make this lone pair also attacking H plus. And then water will be removed. Now, which H plus should be removed? Now, let me put both of the cases. Suppose if you get carbocation here, is methyl, methyl, phenyl, okay, phenyl and OH. This is one path. The other path is, in case if at all I get pH with carbocation here and OH is here, methyl is this way. These are the two possibilities which I get. Okay, but check out which is more stable, carbocation here. Before rearrangement, you can see that the carbocation, this one is much more stable because it is resonance stabilized also. Phenyl ke saath rahega, to resonance mein bhi involve ho jayega. But here it is only forming a simple tertiary group, right? So between these two, if you check out the stability, definitely this is more stable. So this path is not being taken at all. So it will only take the path where it will initially give more stable carbocation. Okay. So therefore, if you have this group which we have to choose, always choose that group where stable carbocation is formed. I think this part is clear, beta, right? So now we know what route it is taking. So this is the right intermediate, this is not. So we got this intermediate sorted out. So what is the intermediate we are getting now? We are getting this intermediate, which we have phenyl, methyl, okay, and OH group is present here. This is how it is. Then carbocation is here. So definitely one of them will migrate. So phenyl will migrate. So as the phenyl migrates here, so we'll get this as pH, ME. This is 1,2 methyl shift. And you would get this as OH with positive charge. And methyl is present here. So that would make that OH to become a keto form here, releasing H plus. So we will have this as, you know, phenyl, methyl with C double bond O, CH3. This is the pinacolone which is formed. Any doubt, beta? So this is second type which we have seen. Now see the third type in it, where you have to choose within the group two different sets are given. So in that case, how do we do this? Okay. Suppose if you have, you know, phenyl here, methyl here, phenyl here, methyl here, and I have OH and OH. So it's not a problem with choosing which direction OH2 is forming. Okay. So definitely if you react with H plus, so let us keep going forward. How much we know that? We know that OH2 will be left. I'm directly writing the step beta. Okay. I'm directly writing carbocation formation. We keep skipping the steps. So pH, methyl, OH. Okay. Now we came into a dilemma, because now we are in that case where we have to choose one of them when you have two different migrating groups. So let me write it as a note. If two different migrating groups are present, then migrate as per migrating aptitude. Migrating aptitude hota kya hai? Its ability to donate electrons. Okay, the one which has more ability to donate electrons, that will migrate easier. Out of which hydrogen migrates most easily. The first preference is always hydrogen. Then it is phenyl groups, that is pH group, okay, with electron donating group on it. Like for instance, if you have this group to be migrated, which has NH2 on it, NH2 is a strong donating group. Okay. So this group will migrate better as compared to only phenyl, or as compared to phenyl with electron withdrawing group. and then tertiary. Okay, suppose if you have any tertiary group like this, this is methyl, methyl and methyl. Okay, tertiary, then secondary. So then we have secondary, methyl, methyl, hydrogen, 2 degree. Then primary, that is CH, CH2, CH3, this way. And then comes methyl. So methyl is a weakest of migrating aptitudes. Right? Methyl does not migrate that easily. Okay. Got it? So this is the migrating aptitude which you need to check. So based on this, if you check out, here the comparison is between phenyl and methyl. So definitely phenyl will shift. So you can say that phenyl will shift here. Okay. And thereby this group would become. Okay, sorry. So thereby this will group will become positive here. Phenyl, phenyl, methyl, and methyl. This is how it would become. Okay. This with OH, and this will close here. And if it closes, what is the product we will get there? Right. So if I'm writing here again. So this product, this molecule will give us a product. Removing that H plus, we'll get this as C double bond O, CH3 with phenyl, phenyl and methyl. This is the final product. So have you understood that, Peter? Yeah. So this is model number 3 type. What is the other type that can be asked? Okay. Now we are doing different types of cases where a similar kind of reaction is done. Suppose I have OH and OH on these two locations. This is also a pinacol with H plus. Okay. Both the sides are equivalent, so I can remove water from any of the side here. So let's say I'm directly going through the steps, okay? I'm not writing each and every steps. So here carbocation is formed, let's say. By removing that water, we got carbocation formation. So once you get this carbocation formation, a group has to shift. Now, which group will shift here? See. Either I have to break bond from here or bond from here. Both are equivalent bonds here. So this bond will close here. So in a way, it is actually ring expansion only. No? So it is undergoing ring expansion. And if I put the count on the ring here, it is now becoming 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So it has become a 6-membered ring. So let me first write down that 6-membered ring with numbering. So with numbering, if I have to do, it is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Okay. So on the first carbon, I already have a 5-membered ring linked like this. This is that 5-membered ring. And on the second carbon, now this oxygen will become double bond. So this would become a double bond. So this is the final product. Is this clear, beta? So in which case, what to do? I hope you understood that. Yeah. Next. Take model number 5. In case, if we have two OH groups like this, one OH is here, one OH is here, in the presence of H plus. So both sides, it is symmetrical. So one OH2 will leave. One OH will be present there. Okay. Now observe carefully. Again, bond has to break. So it would either break from this end because it has to migrate to that. So either it will break from this end or this end. Both of them are same. So let it migrate from here. So now what would happen here? This, if at all, the connecting carbon, I'll take it as 1, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So now it has become a 5-membered ring. So it will become a 5-membered ring here. So let me first show the 5-membered ring with numbering. And I'll write it as 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Okay. So on the first carbon, right? So on the first carbon now, I already have a six-membered ring like this. So I already have a six-membered ring this way. Okay. Got that? And on that, if you see on the same first carbon at this position, there is double bond O. Because this is the double bond O which is forming. Okay. Because abhi dekho na, isme bond ban chuka hai. Imagine this way, the bond is formed somewhere here now. In dono ke beech mein bond ban chuka hai, hai na? तो ये कैसा बन गया है हमको सिक्स मेंबर रिंग जैसा बन चुका है ओके इज दैट क्लियर बेटा या सो लाइक दैट आई हैव लॉट ऑफ केसेस आई विल गिव यू सम एज असाइनमेंट्स यू कैन ट्राई ओके नाउ आई विल गिव वन मोर काइंड सी इफ एट ऑल वी हैव इट इन अ चेयर फॉर्म शेयर फॉर्म में रहेगा तो कैसे सोचना चाहिए सपोज दिस इज द चेयर फॉर्म व्हिच वी हैव लाइक दिस लेट्स से दिस इज द चेयर फॉर्म सो इन द चेयर फॉर्म सपोज वी हैव OH2 प्लस यहां पर बन रहा है CH3 इसको निकालना है OH2 प्लस को निकालना एंड आई हैव मिथाइल हियर एंड OH हियर आई हैव मिथाइल हियर And I have tert-butyl at equatorial position this way. And this is hydrogen. This is how it is. Now, when you remove this OH2, okay, when we remove this OH2 from here, right, the carbocation is forming there. On that, the migration has to happen. Okay. So now, this is a now observe this carefully. Okay, this is an equatorial position. Got it? This is an equatorial position. Okay. Obviously, this cannot move because वहीं पर तो carbocation आएगा. Bond कौन-कौन से टूट सकते हैं? एक bond ये टूट सकता है या ये टूट सकता है. ये दोनों में हमको तोड़ना पड़ेगा. बराबर. Now, which bond will break? So now this is an axial bond. Axial bond is perpendicular, or rather, the orbital which it is forming. See, this orbital is forming something like this. Correct. And this methyl orbital is something like this. This will not give any migration, correct? Migration ke liye parallel orbitals chahiye. Okay. So it is not going to happen. But this is a parallel orbital. See, this is a parallel orbital. This bond, because dono exactly parallel hai, hai na? So ye orbital, agar main dikhaun acche se, ye orbital aisa hi hai. Iska, this is how it is. Aur ye orbital bhi aisa hi hai, correct? So the migration will always happen. Remember, in the chair form, migration will always happen equatorial to equatorial, axial to axial. Axial to equatorial, yeah, equatorial to axial, kabhi nahi hoga. Okay. So hence, this bond will break, and now from this carbon, it will connect to this carbon. Then is that clear? So therefore, we will have a five-membered ring now. First, let me draw that five-membered ring, and if I number that, it is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Okay. So यहाँ से अगर मैं numbering करूँ 1, 2, 3, 4. 4 के ऊपर tert-butyl है, and 5 carbon 1 से जुड़ गया. अभी देखो 1 के ऊपर already एक methyl है, एक water तो चला गया. और एक group है, जो कि ये group है, ये वाला group. Okay, this entire group. Right, ये वाला ग्रुप रह गया अभी सो इट इज दैट ग्रुप सो वन कार्बन विथ डबल बॉन्ड ओ एंड वन मिथाइल ग्रुप ऑन ओके सो इफ इट ऑल आई हैव टू पॉइंट आउट एंड शो यू दिस मिथाइल ग्रुप ओके इज सेम एज दिस मिथाइल ग्रुप ओके एंड दिस मिथाइल ग्रुप इज सेम एज दिस मिथाइल ग्रुप Got it? Oh, मैं एक mistake कर दिया. Sorry, sorry, sorry. इधर इसके ऊपर ना यही तो bond था उसका. Double bond O. And this ME. So, this ME. This ME and that ME same. देखो अच्छे से match करके देखो. Confusion होता है थोड़ा सा. देखो. So this is how you have to do it. Okay, so always anti-migration should be done. Okay. Like this, I have given few examples. I think you can go through that, and then you know, once you're done with that, we'll have a discussion. Okay. क्योंकि सारे में करने से अच्छा आप कुछ प्रैक्टिस करो सारे, ठीक है? That is about glycol. Okay. So glycol and how the diols are formed. Now let us see the next molecule, which is glycerol. Glycerol or glycerin is same. You know what is glycerin, right? It's a thick, viscous liquid. Okay. And it is formed as a side product when we make the soap. Okay. So basically, if you remember soap is actually sodium stearate, sodium or potassium stearate, and so on. Okay. So basically, if you have C17H35OOOH, this is sodium stearate, right? Not sodium stearate. This is the stearic acid. Stearic acid. Okay. इसको अगर NaOH के साथ react करो, क्या मिलेगा हमको? Sodium stearate मिलेगा. C7H35CO- Na+. Now, this is sodium stearate. So sodium stearate is one of the important bases of all the detergents and soaps. Detergent or soaps are either say derived. Hai. Now, suppose if you have CH2O, this connection with OOC, CO and C double bond O, C17H35, okay, and CH2. O, C double bond C17H35. Similarly, CH bond zyada ho gaya. CH2O C double bond C17H35. Okay. This is called triglyceride. Okay. Usually, all the oils which we extract from, you know, different various sources, various essentials, okay, you know, plant essentials, we would get this type of an oil. Now this type of an oil, when you react that with 3NaOH, got it? So this entire molecule will become like this. OH separate ho jayega, and I will get 3 moles of 3H17H35CO- Na+, and this is the soap which we use. Okay, so sodium stearate aise banta hai. Usually, okay, oil se kaise banta hai? So oil se jab sodium stearate banta hai, right? Got it. Then sodium stearate is a salt. The soap which we use is a salt, but it would have some amount of glycerin added. Okay, so this is the part which we add, correct? Just for that. What do you say? Smoothness, which we need to get it in the soap. Okay. So this is glycerin. Okay. So this method of preparation of soap is called saponification. Saponification is basically you take an ester, and react that with base to form a soap. Okay. Sometimes what we do, you know, certain glyceraldehydes already have NaOH present in it. When you rub it on the body or normally rub it on the clothes, right, that NaOH would instantly react with that and gives away soap. So that's how it would happen. Now, anyways, our agenda is most to understand with the glycerin. So let's see that. This is the first way of trying to find out glycerin. What is the second? Okay. If you have CH2 double bond CH2 propene, when you react it with selenium dioxide, remember selenium dioxide you know, will always give allylic oxidation. So here we'll have OH formation. This is allylic oxidation. And once you get that, with Bayer's reagent, cold dilute KMnO4. Remember Bayer's reagent? What will it do? Hydroxylation karta hai. So you'll get this as OH groups on both of these positions. So we'll get this as OH, OH, and OH. Again, glycerin. Okay. So this is the way we can usually prepare it. Got it? So we take a propene. Propene to easily mil jayega. We then react with selenium dioxide. We will give allylic oxidation. Once we get the allylic oxidation and get an alcohol, react that with cold dilute KMnO4. Okay. These are the ways of preparation. Now let us see about the reactions. First, in case if this glycerol has been treated with red phosphorus and I2, जो कि अभी हमने glycol के साथ देखा था, so I can directly write the steps now. So imagine all those water molecules has been removed, I mean OH has been removed, and iodine से replace कर गया. Simran, are you there, beta? So, you know, I told you that two iodines cannot stay stable at adjacent carbons. They would immediately come as I2. So, what I will get here, yahan pe iodine aa gaya aur yahan pe double bond aa jayega. Okay. So, I'll write it in a better form. So, I'll get something like this. So, I'll get this double bond and an iodine here. This is what I'll get. Now, once I get that, well, basically it stops here if at all I react that with red phosphorus HI. But we have seen the same thing with concentrated HI also. So if this reaction is done, the same reagent here, same glycerol. If you take the same glycerin and react that with concentrated HI. Okay. And imagine I go with excess. Okay. I'm not stopping at one mole. I'm going for excess. So in that case, what it is done, first I will replace everything with iodine. This is the first thing it will have. So that means I have consumed 3 moles so far. Saath mein moles bhi count karte rahenge. 3 moles of HI has been consumed. Next, HI is unstable. I on all the positions is unstable. So first to get this form for me, iodine with double bond. This is what I'll get. Now again, HI will react. HI will undergo addition reaction now. Okay, as it undergoes addition, what do we have? Upar humko mil jayega CH3, yahan pe mil jayega CHI and CH2I. Okay, so I consumed 1 mole here. Correct. Now if you observe, again I2 is forming here because adjacent iodides are there. So again, these two adjacent iodides are unstable. So they would again come out as I2. So if that comes as I2, what do we left out with? CH3 and a double bond. And propene, which he has started with. Okay, propene, we got a propene here. Then again, if at all I react with HI, we will get iodide at the center, Markovnikov's addition, and you'll get this. So I got consumed 1 more mole here. So how many moles have been consumed? Total moles. Total number of HI moles consumed is 5 moles. Okay, so this is the overall reaction. Ye aa sakta hai J advance mein as an integer type or as a product to be asked. So you just need to know what will happen. So beta, next, another type of reaction with glycerin, reaction with KHSO4. How does it react with KHSO4? So basically, if you have glycerin and we react that with KHSO4, KHSO4 is a very good dehydrating agent. It would immediately remove out water, okay, and get some stable form. So here if you see the OH group from here and H group from here, this would remove out as H2O, dehydrate ho jayega, and it will form, you know, form like this, a double bond here, okay, and this double bond here with it is having some O minus here, correct? Because OH2 chala gaya to O minus form, okay, and yahan pe bhi humare paas OH hai, okay, yahan pe bhi OH hai, right? Here also we have an OH here, right, and OH2 has gone. So I get this as CH2. One second. Yeah, this is CH2, OH, and H. Oh, sorry. It has already become some kind of a double bond. So, show that. So let me write it as a total molecule to make it easier to understand. OH, CH, OH. CH2OH. Okay. Right. So always dehydration would happen such a way that if you have this OH on the other side here and H on this side here, got it? Alkene banne ke liye hydrogen jana chahiye. Right. So we would have the formation of this. Right. This is how the alkene will go. E2 mechanism. Remember how the E2 mechanism works. So we would have this as CH2 and COH, OH here with double bond CH2. This is how it is formed. Okay. But now imagine the same thing happen on the other side also. So what do we have here now? Fir se agar dehydration ho raha hai. So we will get this as H. We have COH double bond CH2. So imagine again dehydration happen on this side, H2O nikal gaya. So you will be left out with CH, OH, and double bond C. Okay, double bond C, double bond CH2. And this is an enol form. You can see this is an ene, this is an ene and ol form. Enol will undergo tautomerization. So if you undergo tautomerization, we'll get this as C double bond O H, and here it will become CH double bond CH2. Okay. So this is the final product. Right. Now this product is an aldehyde with a double bond on it. Aldehyde with a double bond next carbon, alpha carbon, that is called acrolein. It's called acrolein. This is the product formation with KHSO4. आप ऐसे सोचो बेटा, अगर आपको मैकेनिज्म इज समथिंग ऑब्वियसली दे वांट आस्क यू, बट इफ यू वांट टू रिमेंबर इट दिस वे, आई वुड सजेस्ट थिंक बोथ साइड्स आपने वाटर हटा दिए, ओके, दोनों साइड से वाटर हटा दो तो एक ओएच तो बचा रहेगा, बिकॉज वन ओएच विल बी रिमेनिंग एट वन साइड, सो दैट ऑक्सीजन ओएच व्हिच इज लेफ्ट दैट इज अंडरगोइंग ऑक्सीडेशन, बस दिस इज द प्रोडक्ट. The next reaction is with, you know, oxalic acid. The same type of reaction what we saw for glycerol, I'm doing it for glycerine also. So with CH2OH, if you react that with oxalic acid plus COOH and COOH. Here we have two cases. If we heat around 110 degrees, we form HCOOH plus CO2. If you heat around 260 degrees, it will go for dehydration and you form CH2 double bond CH and CH2OH, which is allyl alcohol. Allyl alcohol. Again, no mechanism. Okay, just kabhi na kabhi to yaad karna padega. As of now, don't worry about abhi kaise yaad hoga. It is only just during the advanced time you have to remember. It is not there for mains either. Next, you see, next reaction is about reaction with HNO3, concentrated HNO3. So if you have CH2OH, CHOH, CH2OH, this ring, and we treat that with HONO2, think more like an acid-base reaction. 3 moles of nitric acid has been used. So यहाँ से ऐसे सोचो कि ये H plus और H ये निकल गए. So what do we get here is CH2ONO2. This is CH, not CH2. Okay, this is what is for. This is called TNG, okay, which is trinitroglycerin. Trinitroglycerin, okay, also known as Noble's oil. The common name is Noble's oil. Okay, it is highly explosive, and used as a dynamite. See how simple it is to make a dynamite. So just take a glycerin and add it with concentrated HNO3. It will become an oil. It will become like an oil substance. And that oil substance, if we give any pressure on that, it would immediately explode. Okay. Right. Next, this is an important reaction, which is the last reaction of this chapter, alcohols. Now, this is iodic acid reactions. Iodic acid reactions. Got it? Mechanism never asked, but you just need to know the trick how to do the questions. Bus. Okay. So, how this has been done? Let's see. Suppose if you have CH2OH, okay, and you treat that with HIO4, iodic acid, periodic acid, okay. So when you treat with periodic acid, how does the reaction takes place? Okay, there is a mechanism for it, but again, it is not needed. I'm just showing you the trick what to do. Okay, you have to break carbon-carbon bond wherever the OH-OH are coming. You just have to break those bonds. It's as simple as that. While breaking, what we need to take care of? When you break the bonds, right? So obviously you are breaking the bond above and below. Here also breaking the bond above and below. So think this way. You give one OH above and one OH below every time you break the bond. Here also you will give one OH above, one OH below. This is a simple trick to do the questions. Aap dekho, yahan par abhi sab toot gaye na? Tino part mein toot gaye. Upar wala part kya ho gaya? The upper part has become CH2 with two OH groups. Yeah. Beech wala part CH with OH, OH and one more OH, teen OH aa gaye. Niche wale carbon pe kya hua? CH2, OH and one more OH has come. Correct? To ab dekho. Carbon ke upar 2H to stable nahi rahega, to kya ban jayega wo? Aldehyde, C double bond OH. अब यहां पर एक वाटर मॉलिक्यूल निकल गया तो क्या बच गया? एसिड. ओके, ये क्या बन गया? ये भी एल्डिहाइड बन गया. सो आई हैव यू गॉट दिस? या दिस इज द वे यू नीड टू डू इट. ओके, सो एवरी टाइम यू हैव अ पेरायोडिक एसिड रिएक्शन यू ब्रेक द विसिनल बॉन्ड्स. ओके, नाउ आई विल गिव यू फ्यू एग्जांपल्स. Let us take glucose. Glucose ka Fischer projection likhta hu main pehle. glucose will have CHO, here it will have CH2OH, OH, OH, OH here, OH here, OH here, H, H, H. First of all, stereochemistry से कोई फर्क नहीं पड़ता. So whether OH is on the left hand side, right hand side, it doesn't matter. So when you treat that with para-iodic acid, HIO4, the bond breaking starts. So you need to keep searching for the vicinal diols. Vicinal diol है या नहीं है, यही बहुत important part है यहाँ पर. Okay? So let me show the search here now. First, OH, उसके vicinal पे OH. तो bond काट सकते हैं ना इसमें. So I will start breaking the bond here. First, I will break the bond here. So I can give one OH to this and one OH to this. Next, let us see the next part here. Again, I have with this OH, this is also vicinal. So because that is also vicinal, what I'm doing, I'm breaking the bond here now. And I'll give one OH to this and one OH to this. Okay. Same way. Now what I'm doing, I'm breaking the bond here because ye OH continue hote ja raha hai. जब तक OH vicinal पे मिलते रहेगा मैं उसको OH देते रहूंगा. यहाँ पे भी कंटिन्यू होते जा रहा है. सो आई गिव वन OH टू दिस, OH अप. नाउ इमेजिन दिस इज अपर वन इज एन aldehyde. ओके, aldehyde एक बार बैक इसको देखोगे, aldehyde इज नथिंग बट इट इज कमिंग फ्रॉम दिस पार्ट ओनली, राइट? aldehyde को एज इफ आई कैन राइट इट एज टू OH ग्रुप्स ऑन इट. So I can, in fact, write this aldehyde form as CH, OH, and OH. So main aise likh sakta hun. So aldehydes can be written this way as if there are two OH groups on it. So therefore, if you write this again, so I can break the bond here also, and I can give one OH up and one OH down. Okay. Now let me number all the carbons. So carbon 1, carbon 2, carbon 3, carbon 4, carbon 5, and carbon 6. So let us go carbon by carbon. First carbon, so carbon 1. On carbon 1, I have 3 OH groups now. OH, 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 and H. 3 OH groups, what does it convert into? It convert into an acid. Because imagine this, this OH and H, if at all I remove this, correct? So I'll get this as water out, and that will become C double bond O. And OH is already there, so that makes it HC double bond O OH. Okay, beta. This is about first carbon. See the second carbon. Second carbon has how many OH groups? Okay, if you check out 1, 2, and 3. What about third carbon? Third carbon also has 1, 2, and 3. Fourth carbon, 1, 2, and 3. Fifth carbon, 1, 2, and 3. Got it? So in fact, all the carbons, right, including first carbon, every carbon has 3 carbons on it. So I have another how many moles here? So total I have 5 moles of this, which is forming 5 moles of acid. Is it making sense? Simran, you clear, beta? See the last carbon. The last carbon has only 2 OH groups, 1 and 1. Only 2 OH groups, correct? So what will that form now? So that 1 mole is of C double bond O. Sorry, C, OH, and OH. This is what is formed. No. So which will convert into HC double bond OH. So what we are getting here now? So we got 5 moles of acid and 1 mole of aldehyde. Okay. So this is the importance of glucose. Okay. Glucose, when you react it with HIO4, ye JE mein kaafi baar aa chuka hai. Aapko ye directly likhna aana chahiye ki kitne moles of acid ban rahe, kitne moles of aldehyde ban rahe. So I hope the reaction with glucose is clear. Now let us do with fructose. How does the reaction works for fructose? So let me write the structure of fructose now. This is the Fischer projection of fructose, acetyl CH2OH. Then it would have ketone. Fructose is a ketone form. Okay, glucose is an aldehyde one, fructose is a keto form. So OH, H, H, OH, OH, H, and CH2OH. Okay, so this is the structure of fructose. So I'm copying it so that we can show it in the next side how it looks like. Be smaller. So now let us start breaking it here now. So when you react that with HiO4, how does the breaking begins, right? So now writing, assuming that you understood, dono vicinal vicinal hai, OH, OH. Here again breaking it, dono vicinal hai, OH, OH. Here also there is vicinal. I get this as OH, OH. Okay. Now here, there is a double bond O. Double bond O is equivalent in writing that as two OH groups, ek OH or ek OH, you know? Because these two OH groups will remove out as water, and that is how it is becoming a double bond. So wherever there is a carbon double bond O, always write it as if there are two OH groups. It is for our sake of understanding. So again, it will appear like a vicinal position. So I'll have one OH here, one OH here. And again, OH is the same thing here. So one OH here, one OH here. Okay. So the distribution is clear, beta. Now let us go carbon by carbon. So first carbon, second carbon. Then this is second carbon. So first, second, third carbon, fourth carbon, fifth carbon, and sixth carbon. Okay. So see the first carbon, how many OH groups it has? First carbon has two OH groups. So what will it become? One HCHO. This is carbon one. Okay. Now carbon two, if you check out, carbon two has amazingly four OH groups. If you have four OH groups, do bar water nikal do, kya ban jayega? Carbon dioxide. So carbon 2 has become carbon dioxide. See carbon 3. Carbon 3 is this one. It has 3 OH. Carbon 4 has 3 OH. Carbon 5 has 3 OH. So carbon 3, carbon 4, carbon 5. All of them have 3-3 OH. So what will it become? Acid. So formic acid. Last one, carbon 6. So now if you see the carbon 6 here, it has 2 OH groups. So what does it become? HCHO. So basically, what is the final conclusion we have? We have 2 moles of HCHO plus 1 mole of CO2 plus 3 moles of acid. So this is about the fructose, how it happens. Simran, any doubt? Good. So this is the type of examples you must be aware of. Okay. अभी कंफ्यूजन किधर आता है? कभी-कभी एग्जाम में कैसे कंफ्यूजन करते हैं? सपोज इफ इट ऑल आई गिव यू स्ट्रक्चर दिस वे, आई हैव गिवन OH हियर, OH हियर, देन OH हियर एंड CHO, ठीक है? नाउ आई आस्क्ड यू टू डू यू नो रिएक्शन विद HiO4. नाउ फॉर दिस रिएक्शन व्हाट यू नीड टू बी केयरफुल अबाउट. So in this reaction, what we need to check out, first while breaking, you need to be very cautious. Okay. This is vicinal. So definitely you will break molecule here. Okay. And let me showcase this molecule here. I'll show the breaking here. So if you see that, we will definitely break here because this is vicinal. Now here, first we need to change it. C double bond O hai, to usko hum log change kar payenge. As two OH groups on it. So I can make this as two OH groups. So OH, OH, and H. This is how it is. Yeah. So on that, again, I have to do the breaking. So if I break here, again, I'll have to break it this way. So on doing that, what do I get now? Check out. Okay, on doing that, I'm getting this side. This is first side. You can check out CH3. OH OH देना start करता हूँ मैं यहाँ पर OH यहाँ पर OH दे दी. So इस कार्बन पे दो OH है. So which means I'll have CH3 C double bond O. Okay. So this is carbon one, carbon two. So one two are done. Okay. Next. If you see on this side, I'll give one OH here and one OH on the other side. So this is 3, 4, 5. So carbon three also has CH double bond O. But carbon 4 has CH2, then carbon 5 has C double bond OH. And next, carbon 6 has 3 OH groups, so which means it will become acid. This point is clear now. Samajh mein aaya beta kaise karna hai? Right. So only at the vicinal positions we have to break the bond, not at all positions. Okay. So aldehyde hai, to usko alcohol ki tarah dikhao, fir break karo. OH distribute karo, it makes very easy for problem solving. Okay, this is one very particular area and most commonly asked. This point is clear now, right? Yeah. So this is about alcohols, beta. So when it comes to alcohols, this is how much you need to know. Okay. So we would have two types of ethers here: symmetrical and asymmetrical. If both the side alkyl groups are same, we call it as symmetrical ethers. If they are different, we call it as unsymmetrical ethers. For instance, here you can see this is a symmetrical ether. Dono taraf methyl groups are. So the common name we call it about ether is dimethyl ether. A UPAC name, how do we find out? We'll take this entire thing as a substitute, and this is the main chain. So we will call it as methoxymethane. We call it as methoxymethane. And same way here also we'll find out one. You can see here we will find out 1, 2. This is the main chain, and this will be the substitute. So this is called methoxy. Okay, methoxy. This is methoxyethane. So this is methoxyethane. Got it? Got it. So that's how we need to check out. From here, if we check out, it would be 1, 2, 3, and this is methoxy group on it. So we'll write it as methoxy 2-methoxy propane. Okay. Like that, if it is on benzene, the IUPAC name is methoxy benzene, and the common name is anisole. Its common name is anisole. Okay. So if you have OET, it is called ethoxy benzene. And the common name is phenetol. Okay. Next, if you have an epoxide like this, got it? This has two names. One is a simple oxyrene. We call it as a simple oxyrene. Or the other IUPAC name is 1, 2 epoxyethane. Epoxyethane. Just humne likha common name wahan pe. It is actually 1, 2. Agar mention kar doge, it is going to become IUPAC. So 1, 2 epoxy ethane. Same way here also, you write it as 1, 2, 3, 4. We write it as either IUPAC name, we can write it as 2-ethyl oxyrene, or we can write it as 1, 2 epoxy butane. Both of them are acceptable. Same way here, if you check out, it is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So we write this as 2, 3 epoxy, and there is methyl also. So we write it as 2-methyl pentane. Or you can write this as 2,2-dimethyl 3-ethyl oxyrene. Okay. So these are the ways to represent ethers. Now see, we can write this as oxyrene. Okay, if you have 4-membered ring, it is called oxytane. If it is 5-membered ring, it is oxylane. 6-membered, oxane. If it is 2 OH, then it is called dioxane. Okay, 1,4-dioxane. These are the common names for, IUPAC name for cyclic groups. When it comes to alcohols, water and ether, if you check out. Ethers, if you compare that with alcohols, here methyl groups are bulky, so they will repel each other, so bond angle increases. While in alcohol, we have methyl and hydrogen, so bond angle doesn't increase to that extent. But when it comes to water, the lone pair repulsion will be such, right? The bond angle is almost 104 degrees. Okay. Phenyl will also have a lot of repulsion from phenyl group here. Right? So because of which bond angle is slightly more than that of alcohols. Okay. So if at all I have to write about the order of bond angles now. So why bond angles? We'll see. Ethers will always be more compared to that of phenols, compared to that of alcohols, compared to that of H2. This is the bond angle. Okay. Now, why we are discussing about bond angles here? See, this bond angle will decide how the reactivity happens. Okay. Because if the bond angle is more, then definitely the electronegativity on oxygen increases. Okay. If electronegativity increases, now if you consider phenol, this giving lone pair or this giving lone pair, then alcohols will give lone pair much easier than ethers. Okay. Now let's see the preparation. Majorly one important method for preparation of ethers is Williamson synthesis. Okay. So here what we do, suppose, imagine if at all I have an alcohol, ROH, I have an alcohol, and that alcohol, if I react that with sodium metal in ether. Okay. Sorry. Sodium metal in ether immediately releases electrons. And that electron will take away this H and we will get this as RO minus Na plus and half H2. Okay. So this RO minus is called alkoxide. Alkoxide. Sodium alkoxide. So first generate an alkoxide. Now that alkoxide could be primary, secondary, tertiary, benzyl, vinyl, phenyl, allyl. Any form of alkoxide you can prepare. And you react that with RX. Any RX, desired RX. And that R should be primary, allyl and benzyl only. Secondary, tertiary does not give that strong reaction. Should be primary, allyl or benzyl only. So on reaction with that, this is a completely SN2 driven reaction. So attack and removal will be simultaneous. That is why, and you know that SN2's most favorable conditions are these three. That's why reaction is only happening with allylic, benzylic and primary. So then you will end up having an ether formation. Okay. So this is the mechanism of Williamson synthesis. Okay. So 1 degree alkyl halides with 3 or more carbons will give E2. So in case if you have formation of bulky substituted alkyl halides, you will get alkenes. So we'll see that how it is going to come. So if you have 2 moles of RX and you react that with Na2O, then also you will get an ether. How it is, let's see. If you have Na2O, Na2O is nothing but 2Na plus O2 minus. O2 minus is a strong nucleophile. So imagine karo O2 minus 1 mole of RX ke saath react kar raha hai. It would attack here and remove X. So what do you get? You will get this as RO minus. And I already have second mole, RO minus plus RX, which is already there. So this RX, this will attack with that. Remove this and you will get it as ROR. So dry Ag2O or Na2O, both will have same effect. So they will give this kind of ethers. Next, from alcohols. From alcohols, we have two set of reactions. One, if you react that with concentrated HNO3, okay, and this is below 400 degrees. So if you go above 400 degrees, it will give ethene. Elimination ki taraf chala jayega. See how the mechanism is. Suppose if you have C2H5OH and reacting that with concentrated H plus. So the lone pair will accept this H plus. You will get this as CH3CH2OH2 plus. Got it? Now, OH2 plus is a good leaving group. So the second mole of alcohol, which is CH3, CH2OH, this lone pair will attack on this carbon, remove this group by SN2. Because यहाँ पे कार्बोकैटन अनस्टेबल है इसके लिए SN2. If the carbocation is stable, then it will go for SN1 reaction. So that group is removed. So I'll have this as CH3, CH2, O, CH2, CH3. So this is the product which you have. So that is what we have written here. Okay. But this is happening at lower temperature. That means lower than 400. If it is higher than 400, what would happen? Now the same reagent, if you think this way, CH3, CH2, OH. Now the same lone pair will extract hydrogen from here, and this OH2 will leave, and this will become alkane, CH2 double bond, CH2 by E2 mechanism. Okay. So therefore, this is at high temperature. At high temperature, that means around 500 kelvins and above. Here, this is at less than 400 kelvins. Simran, is that point here, beta? Okay. The same logic is to be applied when you take Al2O3 around 250 degrees. Up to 250 degrees, it will give ethers. But if you go around 350 degrees, you will get this as alkenes. Okay. Logic is same. Same type of reaction. Pehle AlO2. H plus ke badle mein yahan aluminium chala jayega utna hi. So oxygen will combine with aluminium. That entire group is removed and it will form an ether form. Next, you can see that ROH, this is first Williamson synthesis, because pehle yahan pe RO minus banta hai, kyunki sodium ke sath react kare ho, to first RO minus banega, usko attack karega, I ko nikal dega, so we'll get this as an ether. Williamson synthesis, which is favored by SN2 mechanism. If you react this with CH2N2, CH2N2 kya hai? Dekho, we have ROH here and CH2 and N2. N is actually N, triple bond N with plus and minus. This is how it is. Got it? So N2 is a very stable group. So it will easily nikal jayega. If it goes away, this would become a carbene molecule. Carbene is an electrophile. So imagine as if ROH ka jo lone pair hai, the lone pair attacks on this. So what do we get here now? We'll get this as R, O, H, and CH2 minus, and this is plus. So this will accept this H plus, and you'll get this as ROCH3. Okay. So this way you can have the formation for ether. Okay, beta. The same logic can be applied in here also. In the third case, this is CH3S double bond O, double bond O. Sorry, OCH3. We have this as OCH3 and OCH3. Iske upar socho, ROH attach ho raha hai. Okay. This is a best leaving group. It will attack on methyl. This entire group will leave. Okay. Dono taraf se aise hi ho jayega. One mole from this side and one mole from the other side. Will attack here. This group will leave. Okay. So what we will get is SO4 2 minus. Plus 2 moles of this. Okay. So this is also an SN2 mechanism. Simultaneous attack, simultaneous removal. Yeah. Next. Anisole. If you need to prepare anisole, what we should do? Phenols, when you treat with CH3Br, okay, in the presence of NaOH. See, in the presence of NaOH, phenol is acidic in nature. So it would always become phenoxide ion. This O minus, which is forming, it is called phenoxide ion. So phenoxide ion will again make SN2 mechanism, right? So this is also Williamson synthesis. So Williamson's synthesis. Okay. Same reaction what we have done above. I'm doing the same reaction below with phenol. That's all. So this time also we'll get this as phenol. मैकेनिज्म मैंने दिखा है, थर्ड वाला भी मैकेनिज्म मैंने दिखा है, सेम बिल्कुल वैसे सोचे तीनों केसेस में. नेक्स्ट फ्रॉम एल्किन्स. ओके, ऑक्सी मेरक्यूरेशन डी मेरक्यूरेशन, इफ इट ऑल यू रिकॉल हियर, राइट? सो व्हाट वी यूज्ड टू डू, इफ यू हैव दिस एंड वी ट्रीट विद दैट, यू नो, एनी मेरक्यूरी सॉल्ट Hg2+, okay, then we used to have a mercuric bridge here. We used to get this as a mercuric bridge. On that, we used to add water. But in case of water, if you add methanol, right? If you add methanol here, Me2OH, this is methanol. Then the lone pair will attack here, sorry, on the more stable carbon and removes this group. So I will get this as OME. We'll get this as OME here with mercury present here with plus, and this on reaction with NaBH4-, which is a hydrogen donor. So this group mercury will come out as Hg and hydrogen will come here and OME will come. So what happened? This is the same group. So we got this as secondary position ether. Same is the case with MuOH also. First pi bond will attack on H plus, you will get a carbocation. Okay, on the carbocation, MuOH will attack. So the lone pair on oxygen will attack as a nucleophile. We'll get this. This is by addition. This is simple addition reaction. Okay. Yeah. Oxirenes we just discussed already. You know, oxirenes abhi humne dikhe. This is syn hydroxylation. अभी मैंने आपको पढ़ा दिया था कैसे हाइड्रोजिलेशन बनाते हैं एसिड्स के साथ. MCPBA से पेरोक्सी एसिड. ओके, MCPBA मतलब मेटा क्लोरो. दिस इज मेटा क्लोरो पेरोक्सी बेंजोइक एसिड. दिस इज मेटा क्लोरो पेरोक्सी बेंजोइक एसिड. कोई भी पेरोक्सी एसिड के साथ, यही नहीं, कोई भी पेरोक्सी एसिड के साथ रिएक्शन यही होगा, सिन हाइड्रोक्सिलेशन. सेम Ag2O के साथ, देखो Ag2O के साथ मैंने क्या बोला था, O2 को हमेशा O2- की तरह सोचो. ओके, सो दिस पाई वुड अटैक फ्रॉम वन साइड, O विल अटैक फ्रॉम द अदर साइड एंड यू विल गेट दिस. ओके, सो दैट्स अबाउट द प्रिपरेशन. ओके, अनदर वे ऑफ प्रिपेयरिंग इज हाइड्रोहैलिन. हाइड्रोहैलिन मतलब ये सब इंट्रामोलिकुलर हो रहा है. इंट्रामोलिकुलर कैसे हो रहा है, देखो सपोज इसमें से आपको पता है कि क्लोरीन इज अ बेटर लिविंग ग्रुप. एज क्लोरीन इज लिविंग, इमीडिएटली इंटरनली यहाँ से OH- इसको अटैच कर जाएगा. ओके, सो यू विल गेट एन इंटरमीडिएट लाइक दिस. ओके, यू विल गेट एन इंटरमीडिएट लाइक दिस, OH विथ पॉजिटिव चार्ज, राइट? एंड OH- इसको अटैच कर लेगा एंड यू विल गेट दिस प्रोडक्ट. ठीक है बेटा, और ये रिएक्शन OH- के साथ और अच्छे से फैसिलिटेट होगा. पहले ही OH- अगर अटैक कर दोगे तो रिएक्शन तो और तेजी से हो जाएगा. सो OH- में रिएक्शन और फास्ट होगा. OH- नहीं है तो भी रिएक्शन होगा बट स्लो होगा. ओके, नेक्स्ट, इन दिस केस इफ यू हैव ट्रांसफॉर्म हियर, सो एक तरफ से देखो OH- इधर से आ रहा है, H+ निकल रहा है, O के ऊपर माइनस आ रहा है, इज अटैकिंग हियर, क्लोरीन इज लिविंग, सो यू विल गेट दिस इपॉक्साइड. But this time, when it is in a cis form, it won't happen because this is axial bond. Just now I told you, right? Axial will only be replaced by axial. Equatorial will only be replaced by equatorial. This is at equatorial position. Okay. So there won't be any kind of attack from this end. No attack. So no reaction. Okay. I guess that point is clear. Yeah. So, but this OH, what it will do? This OH will only directly replace this Cl minus. Okay. So externally, nucleophile SN2 mechanism se ho jayega. Okay. So you will get this transform. Okay. Same, yahan par sodium ke saath react karenge to O- aayega. O- will come and close the ring, remove Br. So you'll get this. Okay. Oxalane. Right? That is about the preparation reactions, how it is. Okay. Another way, if you check out here about the stereochemistry, how does the stereochemistry changing here? Check this. Now, on reaction with OH minus, first H plus hata dega, right? And then O minus will attack on Br. It would attack exactly on the opposite side, correct? So first, we need to, this is the Sauer's projection of the given conformer. Now, in this given conformer, imagine this H plus is lost. So we have O minus. But Br is not on the opposite side, correct? So, pehle Br ko opposite side banana padega. To iske liye pehle hum log isko ek 120 angle ke saath ghuma rahe. Ab ghumane ke baad, now the O minus which is present, it will attack at the same time Br will. Okay. Got it? So, on doing that, now you can see methyl has become on the opposite side, right? Two methyls have come on the opposite side. So, now what product we got is trans. ये सिस का ट्रांस बनता है या ट्रांस का सिस बनता है ये आपको डायग्राम डाल के ही पता चलेगा. सो एवरी टाइम यू हैव अ प्रोडक्ट लाइक दिस यू कैन ऑलवेज चेक आउट द डायग्राम एंड गेस व्हाट कुड बी हैपनिंग. ओके आई गेस दैट पॉइंट इज क्लियर बेटा. नाउ लेट्स सी द प्रॉपर्टीज. व्हेन इट कम्स टू प्रॉपर्टीज ऑफ ईथर्स व्हाट आर थिंग्स यू नीड टू टेक केयर ऑफ. सी by nature, right? So this would have two lone pairs on it. So definitely there would be dipole moment on this direction. So hence it is definitely polar. And there is no protic hydrogen. Hence it is called polar aprotic solvent. And because there is no hydrogen bonding, it will have low boiling point. Okay. ETOH will have more than MeOMe because it has hydrogen bond. Okay. So it is always used as a solvent because there is no protic hydrogen and it will dissolve the, you know, even a slightly as polar molecules. So thereby it is always used as solvent and generally it is unreactive, correct? So that's why it is used. So lower ethers are soluble in water. If you take lower ethers, so it is soluble. But as you go towards the higher alkanes, as the R group increases, solubility decreases. So if you see the solubility order, we can say that methoxymethane is more soluble compared to that of methoxyethane, okay, ET, compared to that of ethoxyethane and so on. This is about the solubility. Okay. So far clear, beta? Yeah. Okay. So what we'll do next class, we'll start doing with the reactions. Abhi yahan se thoda sa time lagega. Right. So what are the types of reactions we have? And relatively, it's a very small section. Ethers and phenols are relatively small sections. So I think it should be done by next class. Okay. Right. So one second.